The US left Afghan airbase without notice. New commander was not informed before the American troops' departure. So pullout of troops over 90% complete. That's what he's saying. So look at this. US left Afghanistan Bagram airfield after nearly 20 years by shutting off the electricity and slipping away in the night without notifying the base. New Afghan commander who discovered the Americans' departure more than 2 hours after they left. What lies ahead for Afghanistan after US exit? So, like I said, this all happened, the occupation of Afghanistan happened in 20 years ago when the country, when the international scenario witnessed a cold war between the Russia and America. And both were the two powers, it was a bipolar world, superpowers, two superpowers, and each trying to outsmart the other and win the battle against each other in that mad race for arms, mad race for technological superiority, mad race for their presence, army presence everywhere in the world. So as a part of that, US invaded Afghanistan or took control of Afghanistan in the name of keeping peace, maintaining peace, bringing peace, establishing peace in the region. Whereas ideologically, it was a capitalist government, USA, the capitalist government, trying to prevent the invasion of the communist government, that is Russian government, who also tried to get entry into Afghanistan. So there was this check kind of thing. USA entered so that they can check the Russian entry into the Afghanistan. So while the fight was between Russia and USA, all that has receded now, you know, Great Berlin Wall has collapsed and then the bipolar has maintained into now only unipolar. Now, of course, it's a free place and then it's a multipolar world as it is called now. So if you look at the background, they wanted to establish peace. After 20 years, after fighting against Taliban, they now left the place very conducive for Taliban to take over. In fact, they have a USA peace plan included talks with Taliban. So US troops departed from the Bagram air base that had helped coordinate its long drawn war in Afghanistan. This effectively marked the end of their military operations in the country. So you see, they left without even giving a warning. And so that was the effect. Without any warning, they left. US troops departed from the Bagram air base that had helped coordinate its long drawn war in Afghanistan. This effectively marks the end of their military operations in the country. So what lies for Afghanistan after US exit? Well, you know, US Taliban deal. In a bid to end its war in Afghanistan, the US reached a deal with the Taliban in February 2020. But the deal dealt with four aspects of the conflict: violence, foreign troops, intra-Afghan peace talks, and the use of Afghan soil by terrorist groups such as Al-Qaeda and Islamic State. So they said they will not allow the violence in Afghanistan. They also will have 600 to 700 troops and safeguarding the American embassy and other embassies and to handle any eventuality so that they will refuse Afghanistan to be used the soil for terrorism. Afghanistan soil should not host any terrorism and to protect them against any Al-Qaeda or any such Islamic Jihad groups. While the Taliban promised to reduce violence, join intra-Afghan peace talks, and cut all ties with foreign terrorist groups, the US pledged to withdraw all its troops. Ironically, Taliban, against whom US fought all its state for the entire 20 years, now has promised to enter a peace talk with the deal with the Taliban, and it promised to reduce, and Taliban promised to reduce violence, join intra-Afghan peace talks, and cut all ties with foreign terrorist groups. And then US said that under this condition, if Taliban assures all these conditions, then USA will withdraw, and so it has withdrawn. Now there is an increasing Taliban influence because, after all, again, the democratically the elected government actually is not having any say now. Taliban seems to have the say in the matter. Ever since the US troops began pulling out on May 1st, the Taliban have made rapid territorial advances. The number of districts under its control has increased. So, however, much USA did not want it, or Afghan government, democratically elected government of Afghan did not want it, this has happened. Taliban have made rapid territorial advances. and they have taken more number of districts under their control. The American withdrawal has turned the balance of power in the battleground in favor of Taliban. What a contradiction, what a paradox situation, and what an unpromising backdrop for history. And all along they wanted to safeguard the Afghanistan against Taliban, and now Taliban seems to be in power or in command, getting control over the place. So American withdrawal has turned the balance of power in the battleground in favor of the Taliban. As per the American intelligence community, as it concluded, Kabul could fall within 6 months to the Taliban. So very, it's a matter of time before, after taking many control of many districts in Afghanistan, Taliban can swoop towards capital city, and even Afghan will fall to the Taliban, and they will be perhaps totally in control, and pushing the democratically elected government out of its power, boosting it out and bringing a military coup or a coup by the Taliban and boosting the democratically elected government out of the power. So this is the increasing Taliban influence seen in Afghanistan.